In order to understand the importance of white Jesus or any image or symbol to the mind of any person, you have to understand subconscious archetypal programming. Our minds work on subconscious archetypal programming. Every memory we have is stored in our mind as a symbol, as an archetype. This is precisely why our ancestors in Kemet made an entire language out of symbols. People say, why did they go through the difficulty and complexity and cumbersome process of creating a whole system of communication based on symbol? Because they knew somehow in their genius, well, we didn't learn till centuries later, that the mind stores everything as a symbol.
There is a problem in creating an image that you begin to believe actually exists. It's very dangerous. The image of spirituality claims that all of us are children of the Creator, and that there is no one in a place that is higher than anyone else. So the image of that Eurasian Jesus, or that God, or any symbol that would make another human being not be able to identify it from a perspective of its physicality, of the way it looks, is dangerous because it creates a very special club for only people who look like that.
The brain is a symbol storing, associating, and producing machine. So when you show a child a picture of a white Jesus constantly, repetitively, a black child in particular, who's already being bombarded with negative propaganda that suggests that Europeans are more intelligent than African people, the brain, being a associating and a generating symbol machine, will automatically link this picture to the information that I'm being programmed with. I'm being told white folks are superior. I'm being told God is white. If God is white and white people are superior, then why are black people so upset about white supremacy? Because God, the white man, naturally and quite honestly, made white people in his image. White people are here to control us because they are God's people.
And so when you are in an ice age and you are experiencing very harsh climate and weather, your God can only be as great as your perception of the nature around you. And so when you are in a very harsh climate, when you are in a climate that creates the type of background that makes you have to gnash your teeth, makes you envious, and makes you jealous, then the image that you have of your Creator, because of the nature that is in your environment, is going to be the Creator that you create for other people. When you wish to dominate them, and when you wish to control them, you're going to take that image and you're going to supplant it over what they already had.
Europeans, at the class of the Europeans, colonized the image of God. What they did is even more than colonize the image of God. They created an image of God by creating God in the Europeans' image. And then through tyranny, murder, mayhem, and genocide, forced the African world to accept this European image of God. And so when you worship in God, you're worshiping the European, because the only image you got of God is of the European. So you're worshiping your murderer, you're worshiping your rapist, you're worshiping your robber, you're worshiping your genocide. And in essence, you are, in the name of God, committing suicide, spiritual suicide, cultural suicide. And so the European has been very strategic in how they've done this. But they've done it all at the tip of a sword and the barrel of a gun. They didn't do this through persuasion. They did this through murder, mayhem, and genocide.
In this movie, The Son of God, they had all this extra footage from the Bible documentary, and it shows a white God. And they said that they want this movie to be the images that people will see when they close their eyes and imagine God. Now, nobody who is truthful can tell you what God looks like, because nobody has ever seen God. Nobody has ever seen God. And one of the things that I appreciate about Islam is that they don't allow any images of God, because they know no person could see God. But what you have on the part of Europeans is the Europeanization of African spirituality, which they converted into religion. And then they took African personalities and removed their melanin, presented them as Europeans in order to control the image of God that people saw when they prayed. So that's powerful.
If that central figure of your faith system does not look like you, and it looks like another person, then if you love God and respect God and honor God, and God is the most important thing in your life, then the people that look like that God are also going to be very important to you, and more important than you are to yourself. So it is not surprising that you would conduct yourself the way in which you would in reality, because why should you not? It would be natural for you not to honor yourself and your people if the God you worship doesn't look like you.
When we talk about white Jesus archetype, if Jesus is white, then it makes sense why white people are in control, because they are also blessed with the same color as God. So that white Jesus image, I believe, has been one of the most psychologically devastating and destructive images, concepts, strategies, weapons that have been reaped upon black folk, because it's still with us. You talk about psychological residuals of slavery. Whenever I travel the world, I'm likely to run into a white Jesus. We were in Ghana last summer, life-size statues of white Jesus in a blue-black country. The socialization, the indoctrination, the subconscious archetypal programming.
When you consider the fact that 9/10 of the people on this planet are people of color. People classified as Europeans, white people are a minority. So why is it that all the images of God, Son of God, all the angels are all white if they are a minority of people on the planet? So what we're dealing with is the greatest form of brainwashing ever imagined as a means of controlling a people from the inside out.
Remember now, the CIA and the FBI employs hundreds of psychologists. We fail to recognize this, but propaganda is one of the most important institutions of any government. Your ability to control the thinking of the masses is critical to you controlling the masses. You want to control black folk, you have to control black people's thinking. So the CIA, the FBI, the United States government, every corporation employs psychologists to help get past the natural defense mechanisms of the mind and send a message straight to the subconscious. So they're very, very efficient at manipulating people's emotions in order to control their thinking. The church does it. The pastor is a master propagandist. He manipulates your emotions in order to make you more loyal to his church. It's very difficult for people to change their beliefs. That's exactly why it's very important for us to raise our children and socialize them and educate them appropriately with the right beliefs. Because whatever those children believe, by the time they're 12 years old, they're not likely to change it again. If they believe that Jesus was white, they're not likely to change it again, no matter how much information you give them.
But African people have to begin to understand that if you return to an African way of understanding and knowing reality, you'll get over the fear of death. Because the fear of death is the only tool the European have to persuade you to accept his reality, which is your non-reality. And his reality, which is your non-reality, is a configuration of information that is transmitted to your mind that determines how you make decisions and how you make judgments and how you make plans for your future. If your judgments and decisions and plans are based on a misorganization of information, a deliberate disconstruction of information, then there's no plan or decisions you can make in your behalf that would be for your benefit.